So one thing we know as we're trying to help people breathe easier with asthma is that allergies have a big play in this. And when we talk about especially severe allergies, such as anaphylactic reaction, one thing we know in Lincoln Public Schools is that we have over 700 kids that have potential of a severe allergy reaction like anaphylaxis. Can you tell us more about that, Nancy?
Sure, anaphylaxis is a sudden allergic reaction that can be severe and fatal. Anaphylaxis can be caused by a number of things, and most people think of peanut allergies, right? It could be shrimp or fish. It could be bee insects, wasp stings. Latex is one. Also, exercise-induced anaphylaxis. So maybe there's an athlete that's not managing their asthma well enough, and they could go into an anaphylactic event, and it can be very much life-threatening.
So that's why it's also important, again, with the asthma action plan, as we've kept going back to having your provider plan in place, and where coaches fit into that too?
You would definitely want to have your coach involved and be aware of that individual athlete that has exercise-induced asthma, which can lead into anaphylaxis if they're not managed properly. So they would be taking their inhalers, and we covered this in a previous series, taking their quick relief inhaler before they work out, in order to get through their workout safely.
So what are the symptoms of anaphylaxis that people should be looking for?
Well, the symptoms of anaphylaxis are different for everyone, and they involve all different parts of the body. So you might notice the skin flushing, or the face may become very pale. You may have itchiness, you may be dizzy, you may be short of breath. A couple of symptoms that you want to be very mindful of is if the person happens to have an itchy mouth or a metallic taste in their mouth, that is an indication that their upper airway will close off and you would be unable to breathe at that point.
If someone is having those symptoms, what's their next step?
We manage anaphylaxis with epinephrine. And epinephrine is one medication that there's no contraindication for it. In other words, you can give epinephrine safely to anyone and there is no harm, no foul with giving that medication. I have two trainers here. One is an EpiPen trainer and one is called the AviQ trainer. In order to give EpiPen safely, it's important that you follow these steps. So EpiPens come in adult and also junior doses of medication. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to remove the blue cap and you are going to head target the upper thigh of whatever individual that you're using the EpiPen on. And with intention, you are going to go to the upper thigh and hold it in place for 10 seconds. 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 1,000, that's a while. So you need to make sure that someone is securing the individual, holding their legs still, so they're not moving, because if it should come out, you're unable to insert it again after that. So that's very important. So count slowly to 10 with the EpiPen.
Well, and if someone's having that severe reaction, they're probably going to be very scared or nervous. And so having somebody to assist you with that probably is really especially important with kids.
Right. Let them know they're going to be okay and then secure them quietly so that they'll be able to insert that EpiPen into their upper thigh. Okay. Don't even worry about taking the clothes down or the tights down or anything that's obstructing. Just go right through the clothing.
Okay. So what's the difference with the AviQ then?
The AviQ trainer. And this is quite interesting because this trainer is actually going to tell you out loud what to do. And the actual AviQ EpiPen will tell you what to do as well. So the first thing I will do is I'll remove it. And since it's a trainer, it's gonna give me a few extra directions.
Trainer contains no needle or drug. If you are ready to use, pull off red safety guard. To inject, place black end against outer thigh, then press firmly and hold in place for 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Injection complete.
So the beauty of the AviQ EpiPen is that it's talking you through a kind of a chaotic and stressful situation. So following the prompts, listening carefully, and following the directions is going to help you to give the medication effectively and turn the situation around in a positive way.
They do outdate, don't they?
They do outdate, and it's important to keep track of the expiration date. Now, if it's an emergency and you have an expired EpiPen that you notice, still give the EpiPen in lieu of not giving it. And call 911. So it's important to have two EpiPens, and not just because it's good to have a backup, but for some individuals, when they have their allergic reaction, one EpiPen doesn't cut it. So later on, they will have more symptoms and they will need that second EpiPen. There's a lot of percentage of people that have that happen.
Once you've given an EpiPen or an IVQ, what's the next step?
Well, some schools have protocols that they call 911 when they give an EpiPen.
Okay.
Immediately, they call 911. So it'd be individual to the school or the workplace as far as delivering it and if they need to call 911.
What's the best way for people to be able to avoid their allergens or to find out more about that?
One thing to keep in mind is that a child may get stung by a bee and have just a red swollen arm to begin with, but the next time they get a bee sting, they have a more severe reaction. So reactions can be gradually get more severe as they happen.
Our goal in this whole series is to really help our community to breathe easier. We've been really fortunate to have a respiratory therapist expert to help us with this process. So thanks, Nancy.
It's been my pleasure. Thank you, Michelle.